You see, I happen to be the only son and child. So from an early age, my trusted companions, my favorite friends were my books. In the beginning, it was different. It was more of essays, biographies. Then as I entered the legal profession, then naturally the books were of a different kind. For example, we have legal textbooks, books on administrative law, books on environmental law. Then human rights, as you know, are not merely civil political rights, they're socio-economic cultural rights. And there's a great debate about both these rights, how can both be accommodated, or rather can socio-economic rights remain justiciable. There's a lot of writing on that. And that's why you have all of this. I have the International Bill of Rights, which recognizes it. Then the Charter of the United Nations, which deals with it. Human Rights Practice, that deals with the European Court of Strasbourg. And various aspects of human rights, leading from the right to know, and privacy, and various other things. Then we come to the other rights here, other books here. This is one of my great interests is about censorship. In principle, I'm opposed to censorship. But there are certain publications, certain books, which may need to be censored. Now then again, we come to the question of what is obscenity, what is pornography, who decides? Because one man's lyric may be another man's obscenity. So therefore, you have all these books, end of obscenity, pornography, these are these books here. And in literature, mainly it's poetry, various anthologies, ranging from Palgrave to Oxford, Faber, and others. And one of the nicest books of poetry is this Illustrated Library of World Poetry. This is, I think, one of the best. It's very comprehensive, and I think it's the one which I refer to quite frequently. The other form of enjoyment I have and from which I derive great pleasure is music, mainly jazz music. So therefore you have all the CDs here, which I have to struggle to find time to listen to them. And then I have the different books on jazz. And there you have the Britannica. The other kind of books which I like very much is about biographies, particularly of our Indian leaders. I have a number of books on Jawaharlal Nehru. I have this centenary volume which is very good. This is a centenary volume of Jawaharlal Nehru. Then there are various letters. Jawaharlal Nehru, his letters to chief ministers. Very important, very interesting what he wrote to the chief ministers. There's all, most of the Nehru collection is here. Then this is one of the most interesting books. This is a transfer of power from 1942 to 1947. And this gives you what exactly happened. For example, there's one thing here, a letter from Churchill to the Viceroy. Chiang Kai-shek must not see that Nehru or that Gandhi. So Churchill never liked Gandhi and Nehru. The point is, there are only 24 hours in a day. I have to sleep at least for 6 hours, 1 hour for brushing and washing and doing my hair. So where is the bloody time to read the books? So that's why what I intend to do is go on a cruise, 7-day cruise, only with my books.